What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Cryptic, and if you guys are new here, we talk a lot about gaming and the industry and live streaming. So if you guys are interested in that topic, be sure to stick around. And if at the end of this video you found something useful or you found it entertaining, be sure to leave it a like and subscribe to the channel to be a part of the Night Nation. DMZ Warzone has been a thing of much talk lately. It's been compared to Tarkov very heavily, but a lot of the Tarkov vets don't think it brings the same thrill. Me personally, I think this is a great entry-level Tarkov-like game that allows players to experience an extraction type gameplay scenario, so that way they can get accustomed to the PvE PvP aspect of the extraction type genre. Now, a lot of this stuff is kind of watered down, at least at first glance, so I can understand why people that are very heavily into Tarkov thinking that it doesn't scratch the same itch. That being said, I think this is a great beginner extraction game. It gives a lot to offer between PvE and PvP interactions, as well as kind of mission-based and objective-based tasks to go into. Now, do I think that there could be more? Definitely. I mean, this game is in beta, or at least this game mode, so having some tweaks and changes along the way are bound to happen. That being said, do I think everything needs to change? No, not really. I think that the fact that NPCs are a lot harder in this game mode is definitely a breath of fresh air, considering Warzone, the NPC enemies are kind of just there to, you know, kill. But at the same time, I think a lot of the NPC loadouts or like interactions could be different. Right now you're seeing a lot of RPKs, RPGs, shotguns being the base loot with not too much differences. Like, there's not a whole lot of variety in terms of what their loadouts have. So I'd like to see a little bit more on that, or at least being able to edit certain items. Now, if you notice that contraband items are not able to be edited. The only editable weapon that you can use is your insured weapons. And you unlock these at various stages of the mission-based quest lines. Now, I think that the insured weapons being cooled down using money to, you know, lessen the time is a very nice and cool mechanic. It allows people that constantly do raids to get their insured weapon more often, especially if you're able to extract consistently. This game has a lot to offer, and I'm excited to see what kind of developments happen along the line. However, I don't think a lot of it should be trying to reflect Tarkov. Tarkov is a great game in its own right, but there's a lot of complex systems that most, you know, casual gamers don't have the time to really research or look into. This is a nice kind of break from the usual grind until you croak method and just play, extract, and have fun. So I think this is a great game mode. I'm excited to see where it goes. If you guys have different opinions, let me know down in the comments. Let's see where we can take this conversation. Hell, maybe even get some of these brought up to the devs. Who knows? Thank you guys for watching. You guys have a pleasant day, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.